welcome to a cold but, you know, fairly decent Monday. It's one of the last Mondays of the year. I'm thrilled to be your host, Diane Gatzis-Havinga. And here at Channel 6, I meet with my staff on a weekly basis. Well, gosh, I meet with them every day. But at any rate, on a weekly basis. And we talk about, you know, what we're going to be doing and planning out shows. And about a month ago, we were talking about what we're going to do during the month of December. And Avon Price said, well, what about if each of us picks one of our favorite Village in Motions as kind of a retrospect over the year? And what a wonderful idea. We haven't done that. So that's what we're going to do today on a Monday, December 19th. We're all going to be hosting and sharing what we consider one of the highlights and maybe our favorites. I don't know. There's a lot of favorites to choose from over the course of 2016. But as soon as he said that, I knew exactly what show I wanted to recap. And that was The Vet's Row, that I was able to participate with my father right before Memorial Day of this year, when a group of 300, over 150 veterans from World War II, from the Korean War and the Vietnam War, drove by bus from Illinois all the way here to Washington, D.C. to visit their memorials. So, without further ado, let's take a little bit of a look back at Vet's Row.
My brother John and my wife Darlene founded us in honor of our father Cy, who was a World War II Navy vet, and immensely proud of his service to the country. And he passed away after a brutal battle with cancer back in January 2000. And we always wanted to think of something special to do in his memory, and that's kind of what we came up with. Also our mother Barb, who's still living, she's a Rosie the Riveter, and we honor the ladies of World War II as well. And we came up with the idea mainly because we had heard about the Honor Flights and what a wonderful program they have nationwide. We know Earl Morris and Jeff Miller. And we got looking at that, and we're in the RV dealer or RV industry. And so what we did that first year in 2010 is we did it with a convoy of 9 RVs and 3 buses. And we thought we were done, and by the time we got back to Wisconsin, people were calling, signing up for the next trip, and we hadn't even thought about it. And so then we went ahead with Vets Roll 2. Today is Vets Roll 7. It's our 1,325th veteran, including our beloved guest here, Mr. Gatzis. And, it's amazing how it's grown. I think we have people from 33 different states now come into Wisconsin to go on a trip. So, based out of Beloit, Wisconsin. But they come from everywhere. And it's great when the family can come out and celebrate it with them. You got to really appreciate the great fortune you have right now to be able to connect and still share those stories. And I hope you've recorded them, because I never did it with my dad. When I was growing up, they were all World War II vets. And, now they're getting few and far between. So make sure you keep that history alive.
And that's clapping for me.
Are you going to join up?
Think it over.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Not all
thank
bad.
Don't be
straight
away from me.
Get away. Thank you.
You know you're from Wisconsin. Thank you very much.
Where are you from?
Thank you. Illinois.
Man, I'm all
thank you. Too many hands.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate you. Really do. Thank you.
Visit. Thank you for your
thank
service.
You.
Welcome.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for your service. Welcome. Just in case the Shore Patrol or the MP is looking for someone, those name tags become an opportunity.
I'm Vince. How you doing?
I'm Vince.
John, we're watching John all
now,
day.
Thank you for your service.
We're taking care of him.
Right.
Thank you. Take care.
All here. Thank you for your service.
On the trip, we have 200 veterans, and we have 100 support people. There are 10 buses, and I think there are 32 buses. And we started off at Beloit. We left early in the morning. We had the town population was aligned by the streets. They were waving flags as we were leaving. We had an escort of police cars to take us to the highway, and they escorted us quite a few miles before we started on the road. As we were in all different places, we would have escorts. We would stop and have lunch at places. And in one town in Pennsylvania, the whole town was out there. They closed the schools so the kids could come out and wave flags at us as we were getting off. The help that the support group has been great, and they treated us wonderful.
We left out of Beloit, Wisconsin. And my dad is a ex-POW from the Korean War, and I'm accompanying my dad on this trip.
How's it been so far?
Oh, I think everybody's really appreciated it. They really enjoy the fact that they're being treated like kings and queens, and I don't think they could be any prouder of our nation right now when they see the kids on the side of the roads waving flags, the police stopping for us, fire engines on the bridges waving, and it really makes you can see the emotions on their faces. It's really a great experience for all of them, I'm sure. They all love it. I've really enjoyed seeing the patriotism that I'm seeing, because often we don't see that every day. And it's nice to see that and see the expressions on the young troops that we see and meet. We've met them at Arlington. And they actually went up and shook hands with a lot of the vets, and they got a chance to talk to them. And I think it was good for both sides, young and old.
So the video that I chose was something else that happened in May, but an entirely different topic. And in case you're a little confused, my boss, my coworker, and I are all switching out today as we introduce our different segments. So a couple times a year, my coworker, Avon Price, and I will do what we call movie or TV shows. We'll have like friendly arguments about our top five lists of things, varying genres, Halloween videos, funniest moments, best TV villain has been some of our more favorite ones from this year. So I'm zeroing in on something we did last May. It was funniest moments in the movies, and we each shared our top five moments from comedy movies. So let's take a look at that. 13th, and on this gloomy day, as our 13th gloomy day in a row, we're going to try and lift everyone's spirits by going back to the last 60 years of movies and looking at some of the funniest moments in comedy. So I have my fellow film buff here, yep. Avon Price. Thanks for being back, Avon.
I always love these.
So what makes you laugh? What in movies makes you laugh?
You know, my sense of humor is the most random sense of humor ever. I love movies that don't have like a laugh track or anything. Mm-hmm. Like the jokes are subtle. And then some reason, me and my siblings love laughing at like animals for some reason. I don't know. That cracks us up. And I don't know. I have a wide brand of.
So you're not going to be caught watching like the old sitcoms from the 90s with the laugh tracks.
No, I can't. I can't deal with that whatsoever.
You're not being, like, told to laugh when you're going to laugh where you want to.
That's
laugh.
Why I can't stand Seinfeld.
I know. We have a whole other show we can debate.
We'll have to debate that another time.
Bomb you just dropped. So would you agree comedy in the last 60 years has changed a lot?
Yes.
In movies specifically.
Yeah.
How so, do you think?
I think, like what I was just saying about the laughter, I think comedy now is much more subtle. Like, you have to pick up on different lines, and what I like is different facial expressions and stuff like that that makes it just totally different and everything like that.
What I've noticed is that you don't see a lot of the physical humor as much anymore. The slapstick, screwball stuff that you used to see, like Alec Guinness and Peter Sellers do, you know, Three Stooges stepping on a rake, falling over. Mm-hmm. Why do you think that kind of humor hasn't really kept its popularity?
I guess different generation, just trying to do something new. Someone else was tired, like some director was tired of it and just went in another direction.
Because that seemed to be the thing way back when. You had the little comedies with Alec Guinness. This is where my film history geekiness starts to show. The little
I can see it coming
Alec
out.
Guinness, Peter Sellers playing 10, 13 different roles in some movies, and a lot of things is much more physical based and situationally based. And I think now movies like The Hangover, you're seeing a lot more of it skewing to like what they're calling it, the R-rated comedies, which is really popular right now. They're not afraid to be a little more shocking.
I do like dark humor.
Use a little more foul language and get a little more darker in there. You don't always see just sort of more of a clean cut comedy like you used to. And I wish I could figure out why. Maybe today we'll figure out why, because I'm going to be going back and revisiting some of these older comedies.
And I picked more things from my childhood and things relating of that. Much more recent films, as you can say.
That's fine.
And we want to say that this is not a battle like our Batman versus Superman battle. This is more of just a subjective, what I like, what you like, and see what we find in the middle.
Okay. Yeah, and I think this is good because my most recent movie that I'm going to be sharing is, I think, 1975.
Okay.
Yeah. So I'm sticking with the classics, so to speak. All right. So I'll kick it right off. 1975, Young Frankenstein by Mel Brooks, genius Mel Brooks, and I think this is one of the movies where I think this kind of comedy has kind of been lost to the ages, because we had so many comedy legends in this movie. Gene Wilder, who is it, Lisa Kudrow's mother, Terry Garr, you know, she played Phoebe on Friends. Peter Boyle, who just passed away a few years ago from Everybody Loves Raymond, he plays the creature in this movie. Gene Wilder had just finished two flops. He had made a movie called The Producers and another movie called Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, and both of those movies didn't do anything in the box office. So this was his first movie. It's amazing because now they're really well known. So this was his first movie where he really had a huge success, and he was really big after this movie. So this scene is when the creature first comes to life, played by Peter Boyle, and he starts strangling young Frankenstein, and we can see what happens.
All right.
So young Frankenstein.
What? Good! What is it? What's the matter? Quick, give him the...
Watch! Give him the watch! Three syllables. First syllable sounds like...
Head! Sounds like head! Bed! Said!
Said!
Said! Second syllable, little bird!
said a gift?
I remember watching that when I was 10 years old. Like, I just, what, like, what a genius idea to me. Like, you're being strangled, and the way you're going to communicate to tell him to give a sedative is to start playing charades. First syllable sounds like said. Second syllable, I just think it was brilliant.
Speaking about a movie that you saw in your childhood, yeah. I have the movie called Happy Gilmore. And Happy Gilmore, I'm sure you've heard of it. It stars Adam Sandler.
Yeah.
And I remember watching this with my dad. And so it's about a movie of a played out hockey player who never got anywhere trying to now play golf, but he has a bit of a anger issue. So the scene I picked comes from what my last name is, Price, and one of the best known game shows out there is The Price is Right. So here's a scene where Adam Sandler and Bob Barker don't get along. So let's watch that real quick.
I can't believe you're a professional golfer. I think you should be working at the snack bar.
You better relax, Bob.
There is no way that you could have been as bad at hockey as you are at golf.
All right, let's go.
Oh! You like that, old man? You want a piece of me? I don't want a piece of you. I want the whole thing.
Price is wrong.
I think you've had enough. No? Now you've had enough.
And so, you know, we were talking about physical, you know, violence and how that can be played out funny. And what I liked about that, what's so funny, is obviously here you got the young guy, Adam Sandler, versus an elderly gentleman getting creamed by the elderly gentleman known as Bob Barker.
Yeah.
And I just love that whole scene, especially that line of the price is wrong. And that just cracks me up every time.
There's a lot of funny parts in that movie when he actually shoots the guy in the head with the nail gun.
Mm-hmm.
And I think Julie Bowen is in it. Doesn't she play his love interest?
Yep.
She's on Modern Family right now. So that was like 20 years ago. So, yeah. That's a funny movie, and that was one of Adam Sandler's first movies, I think, when he initially left Saturday Night Live and tried to make it in movies like that. Had that and Billy Madison pretty much back-to-back.
And Waterboy. Waterboy was awesome.
Yeah, Waterboy was a few years later. That was a funny movie. That was a funny movie.
I had to choose between Waterboy and Happy Gilmore, and I went with Happy Gilmore just because Bob Barker, you can't beat that.
I forgot that he lost the fight.
Yeah.
Hey, Greg Spring, it's my turn. Your host here, Avon Price. You know, it's perfect that Andrew chose the laughter show that we did. And side note, one of the movies I picked for that show was Mean Girls, of which I saw yesterday, and it was awesome, as usual. But the part I'm going to introduce today, one of my favorite things working here at Greenspring is being able to work with different staff members and putting in different different videos and stuff like that. Together, we worked with the community resource people, and we were working on an episode back in May. It seems like we all chose things in May. Look at that. I chose to do the episode of Laughter Day, and Kelly Lukchen and I went around Greenspring asking residents and staff about different jokes, what makes them laugh, and just hearing their own personal laugh, because we all have different laughs and things like that. So one of my favorite ones from 2016 is from the Laughter Day. So here's a roll-in that Kelly Lukchander and I put together for Laughter Day. So let's look at that.
Oh my gosh. Pardon my laugh, but I can't help it. Sometimes just walking around Greenspring, you'll catch something that makes you laugh or somebody will be smiling. So on this National Laughter Day, we're going around Greenspring to see what really makes people laugh. They got good stories or just what do they find funny? Let's check it out. I want to know, do you know any good jokes?
Oh, good jokes?
Yeah, tell me a joke.
Yes, I do know a very good joke.
Let's hear it.
This car was driving down the road, and the policeman had to stop and tell this lady that she was driving too slow. And he said, "You're only going 22 miles an hour." And she said, well, that's what the sign says right up there. And he said, no, that's Highway 22. Oh, and he said, what's the matter with these ladies in the back seat? They don't look well at all. So, well, we just got off Highway 95.
That is good.
Pretty good.
Yeah.
I can't think that fast. I'm trying to keep a line dance in my head. Go ahead.
Are you sure? Is that okay?
Yes.
Okay. What do you call a nosy pepper?
A nosy pepper.
No, this is just a regular one-line joke. Okay. What's the difference between snowmen and snow ladies? Snowballs.
That's funny.
Yeah. Jalapeno business.
Precious. Good. I gotta remember that one, so you ask me next time.
Okay, see you, Linda.
Okay, this is for everybody that wants to just chuckle today. Okay, how will you know who is your best friend? Is it your dog? Or is it your best friend, like Kelly here? And so here's what I would do just to test it out. I would put them both in the trunk and drive around for a couple of hours and then open the trunk and see who's happy to see me. Would it be the dog or would it be Kelly?
It's not gonna be me.
That's how you know who your best friend is.
That's a good one.
Happy laughter day.
That's good. Show me that laugh.
Oh, no.
Don't be hiding. Let's see you laugh.
I gotta do it today.
Come on. Let's see it.
I gotta do it today.
You got the best laugh in town. Hey, Bob.
What?
Do you know any good jokes?
Do I know a good joke?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's hear one.
Well, have you heard the one about the mother who was knocking on her son's door and said, son, it's time to get up and go to school. And this voice inside of the bedroom said, I'm not going to school. They hate me and I hate them and I'm not gonna go and you can't make me go. And the mother said, well, there's two reasons why I think you should go. First, you're 57 years old. Secondly, you're the principal.
That's pretty good.
That was a good one, Bob.
Or you want? Can I tell you a joke?
You can tell me a joke, yeah.
All right. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Control freak.
Control freak.
You say control freak who?
That's what I was going to say.
That's a joke. Guess it wasn't that good.
Well. One more for you that are on National Laughter Day that want to laugh. Okay. Why does a milking stool only have three legs? Kelly? Kelly doesn't know. Because the cow has the udder one. Good one, huh?
Franklin, can you tell us a joke?
I sure can. You ready?
Yes.
All right, why can't a bike stand on its own?
Why?
Because it's too tired.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Tell me. Do you know any jokes? Do you like to laugh?
I got a long one.
Let's hear it.
Okay, look. This guy had lost his job. So about 2 or 3 weeks, he was looking in the papers for his job. And he seen this one at the zoo. So he said, my car no due, you know, my bills are due. Let me go see what's going on. So he went in there and they said, hey, our gorilla is sick. We need somebody to put a gorilla suit on, jump up and around in a cage until they get well. He said, man, I don't know. He said, look, we're paying $15 an hour. He said, okay. So he put the suit on, next day, jumped up and down in his, you know, cage. And week or two, 3 weeks went past. The guy said, man, the crowd is coming. And you get, you know, it's a great crowd. I don't know what you're doing, but keep doing it. So he did it for another 2 weeks. And the boss said, look, the crowd, so many people's coming in to see you, we're gonna give you a raise. He said, go ahead. He said, yeah, we're gonna give you a $20 raise. He said, $20? He said, that's great. So he was so excited the next day, he went and put the suit on, he jumping up around, and he seen his rope hanging from the ceiling. So he grabbed a rope and was swinging and swinging. Everybody started clapping, yay, yay, swinging. And he went back one time and hit the wall and swing and boom, bust the wall into the lion's cage. The lion jumped up, arr, arr. He started screaming, help, get me out of here, help, get me out of here. The lion walked up to him, shut up, fool, before you get both of us fired.
Hope you enjoyed that, Greenspring. I always enjoy loving, you know, watching the laughter day. It makes put a smile on your face, so I hope they put a smile on your face. Hope you've enjoyed our show today when we remember our top 2016 Village in Motion shows, and we'll be back for 2017, which is just right around the corner.